First, it's the one thing that united us all during lockdown. Inevitably, it will be the thing that divides the competitive among us over Christmas. I'm talking about quizzes. In just a moment, we'll speak to the queen of quizzes herself, Jenny Ryan. But first, let's check out her skills as the vixen on ITV's The Chase.
Staying where you are. Chase has put...
Albany is the state capital of New York.
Hang on a minute. New York?
Mm-hmm.
So where's New York City, then?
It's just a big city in New York State.
How can it be the state be New York and the capital city of the state not be New York, New York? That's what it's called twice. They say it twice. New York, New York.
It's an absolute quiz chestnut that Albany is the state capital of New York. New York is not the capital.
It might be a quiz chestnut because you do quizzes. We don't.
What are you doing on a quiz show?
I love it. Jenny always manages to hit Bradley on the contestants on their tours. Oh, it's lovely to see you here, Jenny. Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
Do you ever get nervous thinking, what if I don't know the answers? Because that's my ultimate fear of quizzes.
I think that's what's changed during my time. I've been there 5 years now. The first year was really tough because there was always the niggling little thought at the back of my mind. If I make an error, millions of people are going to see this and I'm going to be a laughing stock. Once you get past that, so I don't allow myself to get nervous at all. I'm out there just to show what I do know. I can't possibly know everything, so yeah. I don't beat myself up about too many of the misses. Sometimes I do that.
How do you prepare? Are you constantly trying to absorb information?
Yeah, it's, for me, it's like a holistic way of taking in information. I learn from watching the TV, from watching all the box sets, listening to the radio and podcasts. It's continual. Even like adverts when I'm on the train or the tube, you see the billboards. That's all potential quiz questions there. It's just how you take in that information, assess how useful it's going to be, and are you going to be able to recall it in time? Yeah. Other people, like my fellow chasers, love lists. So they will read a Wikipedia article about all the Marvel comics and all the Marvel films. I've just watched them, and that's how I know about them.
That is amazing. And have you always loved quizzes? Is this, like, something that's been your thing since you were little?
Yeah, it's an absolute family habit. So when I was very small, my granddad looked after me. I didn't go to nursery. He was my nursery. He taught me to read and write. He taught me to do maths. And he taught me how to quiz because he was an absolute quiz maniac. 15 to 1, going for gold, all that sort of stuff. And he taught me how... if you don't know something, how to find out the actual answer. So I would find a word that I didn't know how to pronounce or I didn't understand it. He'd tell me where to look to find out more and then give me a more all-round understanding of things. So that's a skill I've picked up from him.
Yeah, what a great relationship as well to have that growing up and for him to teach you so many brilliant things.
He was a brilliant role model. I mean, it's just sad that he's not around to see what's become of me.
Yeah.
It would have been his dream job to be a chaser, so I'm sure he's very envious.
Yeah, what would you say is your biggest achievement quiz-wise then, the thing that you're most proud of?
Outside of being a chaser and all the exciting things that come with that, being able to play for a lot of money, personally, winning Only Connect.
Yeah.
Lots of people don't realise that I was on that long before The Chase. Season 3, I won it with my mates, the Gamblers, and no money. We won one Perspex trophy between three of us, so I've not seen that for about 2 or 3 years because it's on a rotation.
I love that.
Still
it's
proud
on a rotation. Yeah. And you've got a podcast. You mentioned podcasts that you listen to them, but you've also got your own as well, haven't you? Tell us about that.
Yeah, and I didn't start it in lockdown, unlike most people. So I've got a podcast about the world of quizzing. I host it with Lucy Porter, the stand-up
comedian.
Who's
hilarious. Yeah.
She's brilliant, and she's a really keen amateur quizzer. So that's the basis of our podcast, is I'm the pro, she's the amateur, and we talk about our mutual love of quizzing, how she can get better as an amateur, and we look at all the different ways that quiz touches people's lives. When I started it, I tried to explain it to people and say, oh, you might not like it, it's really, really niche, and the more I've gone on, I realise it's not a niche topic, quizzing, because everybody, whether you just get out Trivial Pursuit at Christmas or you watch Pointless with your nan every night, or if you're playing in one of the top quiz leagues or you work in the quiz industry, all those people behind the scenes in quiz shows, quiz is a huge part of so many people's lives on a daily basis. And so there's a lot of joy in there. There's a lot of nostalgia for old shows. So we talk a lot about Going for Gold in particular.
I love it. What would be your, like, tips? Then you were saying, you know, you can't kind of show Lucy as an amateur quizzer how to be better at it. What would you say to people out there about how to be good at quizzes?
I think one of the top tips I can give is just to consume a lot of quiz. So watch quiz shows and think about how the questions are worded, what clues are in there. How can you be presented with a question which you couldn't possibly have known the answer to, but still give a ballpark guess, have those sort of cover-all answers? And if you're presented with a question like that ends in which continent, you've got sort of a, you know, you've got a couple of options there. You can give it a go, give it a guess. Never pass on anything, and always just be thinking, is this bit of information going to be useful for a quiz in future? Mm. Will this come up in my local pub quiz? Make a little note of it as you're reading the paper.
A bit like Margaret Keenan, everyone's written her name down, haven't they? The first person to get the vaccine.
Yeah, but what about the second person?
Yeah, William Shakespeare. I've got that for now. Well, I think we should put this to the test, given we've got the vixen here. We thought we'd have a bit of a quiz with her. So forget Jenny from the block. Let's play Jenny Against the Clock.
I have to COVID secure the seat.
Thank you, Steph. So, today, I'm your quiz mistress. Steph, you and Saida are one team. Woo-hoo. Russell and Anton, you're the other.
Dream.
You've all got buzzers.
Yeah.
So, team test, let's test them out. Steph?
Steph and Saida.
Oh, sorry.
It doesn't matter. Whichever one of you buzzes first, I'll take your first answer. The opposition.
Russell and Anton.
Oh, sorry, I didn't do the count. One, two, three, four, press.
So if you buzz in first, I will take your first answer. If you get it wrong, I'll pass it to the other team and vice versa.
We can't have another
I'm going
go
to
then.
Ask you a series of questions. It's your job to answer as many as you can. Fingers on buzzers, which is also the name of a very great podcast.
Nice.
We're going to have 90 seconds on the clock, so it's basically as many answers as you can in that time. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yes. Was that a question?
Yes,
no
points available
sense.
For that one, Ant. Steph and Saida, are you ready?
Yeah, I think so.
Russell and Anton, are you ready?
We're ready.
Oh,
if I can have 90 seconds on the clock, please.
You can have anything you like.
Why am I nervous? This is ridiculous.
Stop trying to butter me up, Anton.
This is when the competitive
genuine
streak
genuine nerves.
OK, your time starts in 3, 2, 1. Margaret Keenan became the first person to receive what last year?
Russell and Anton.
COVID-19 vaccine.
Correct. How Far I'll Go is a song from which Disney animated...
Russell and Anton.
Moana.
I can't take that first answer. I'll pass
what,
it over.
From Moana?
Moana
is correct. Which DJ came second in this year's I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here?
Steph and Saida.
The DJ who came second in I'm a Celeb was Jordan North.
Correct.
The long time, long
time. In which
time.
Sport would you use a shuttlecock?
Russell and Anton.
Badminton.
Correct. What is the largest organ in the body?
Russell and Anton.
Well, technically the skin, but
correct.
Yeah.
Marie Antoinette is believed to have said, let them eat.
Steph and Saida.
Kick.
Correct. Nick Hewer is standing down as host of...
Russell and Anton.
Countdown.
Correct.
Guessing
the Carolina Reaper is the world's hottest type of what?
Russell and Anton.
It's a chili.
Correct. In 1928, what antibiotic did Alexander Fleming...
Russell and Anton.
Penicillin.
Correct. According to Guinness, what festive classic is the highest grossing song of all time?
Russell and Anton.
Do they know it's Christmas?
No, over.
Oh, is there a candle in the wind?
It's White Christmas. Who does the voiceover on Love Island?
Russell and Anton.
Ian Starling.
Correct. Who won the FIFA Women's World Cup in 2019?
Russell and Anton.
United States.
Correct.
Yes, Anton.
Inaccurately, according to ABBA, where did Napoleon surrender?
Russell and Anton.
Waterloo.
Correct. What is the capital of Iceland?
Russell and Anton.
Reykjavik.
Yes! Oh,
you wrote his name.
That was amazing.
I want to recount.
This is Team Evil Genius, also the name of a great podcast.
Yep.
What do you mean, do it again?
Full on Trump on them.
Yeah. I'm just having my John Watson moment. The scores are coming through on the mini printer.
Moana.
Steph and Saida, you scored 3.
Well, disappointing, as we like to call it.
Russell and Anton scored 10. So you are on today's quiz. Congratulations, gentlemen.
Fake news, guys. I've got to tell you, it's fake news.
So that's what it feels like to win. I love that.
Amazing. Yes. Put your hands together for Jenny Rose.